there any more questions? You gotta come to the microphone.
Jim, I have the same point. We're hearing conjecture. I don't wanna hear conjecture, $100 million. I wanna hear facts. And I don't wanna hear a certain person's agenda. I wanna hear facts, not conjecture. So let's.
What facts haven't you heard?
What you're about to tell us.
Well, I'm honestly, I'm not sure I follow the question, but I think I had said before that I would talk a little bit about our visit with the EPD. Commissioner Levent and I went down there on Wednesday. And we met with the head of the EPD. Tim Perkins went with us, as did Doug Darrow, the county manager. And we spoke for an hour or so with them. And we brought up the issue that the county had been turned down for our withdrawal from the Chattahoochee River because of the Magnuson case. We pointed out to them that it was in fact the EPD itself who declared that Forsyth County is a hardship, not a hardship because of what Magnuson may or may not have meant, but because we were already bumping some of the thresholds of the water that we need. We also, as a group, in a variety of ways, tried to tell them that as a result of that, they also had given what I believe to be our allocation of water, at least some of it, which is supposed to be determined by need. In other words, do you need this water, not would you like this water? That some of our need was in fact put into the computation for the city of Cumming in order to sell us finished water. And they don't, in my opinion, have necessarily a need to sell us finished water. And my point, and I think Todd's too, was that in a way the EPD has legislatively put us into a position of having to purchase water from one and only one source, and it's sort of a trap we can't get out of. Furthermore, Tim Perkins pointed out, as he said in the slide before to the EPD, that although their actual order to the court, this is Judge Magnuson's court, and then back to us, said they would not issue any permits for people who are in our river basin. The fact of the matter is that it appears, and Tim brought up, that they had given Roswell a permit which is in our river basin. EPD initially said that was for a well. Tim challenged them on that, and Tim seems to have been able to determine since then that in fact Roswell got both a permit for a well and for withdrawal from there. So the main point is that we, right now in terms of allocation, we're trapped by the EPD. Now they offered to look at this. I didn't get a warm fuzzy. When I asked them when they could get back to us, they told me it would take 2 weeks before they could tell me when they could get back to me. And so that's kind of how it goes, and I think that's the tenor of what Tim has been saying about our regulatory agencies as they relate to Forsyth County. Those were those issues. We also brought up with them that, in kind of our general opinion, the fact that Forsyth County doesn't have a permit, in other words, a name on an intake, we have sort of a logical permit that piggybacks onto the city, but we said there's 170,000 people here who we believe are essentially invisible to you, the EPD and the Corps of Engineers, because you're going to manage lists, names of places that have permits, and you're going to say this area gets X number of gallons in this, and what you're going to see is the city of Cumming, which is roughly 5,000 people. They did not at any point disagree with me on this, but they didn't particularly say, yeah, you're right, we just manage lists, but at no point did they say, don't worry about it, we're going to take care of you.
They did indicate to us that they would actually cater to the thought of adjusting the permits, who gets more, who gets less. But what they did clearly say is they would not at this time look at increasing any permits. And that's when we also brought up the fact that based on the argument that their own department director made, Carol Couch, in the Madison trial, Rawls will obtain some permits. But yet they used our county as their argument, and we still don't have the permits. So it was interesting. We were fortunate enough. We had some state delegates show up. Mike Dudgeon came, Mark Hamilton came, and Senator Murphy were there. But out of the three of them, only one of them looked square in the eye of the director and asked him if he would please work with the county and do everything you can in your power.
Which one?
Mike Dudgeon did that, of course. And I don't know where the other two truly stand. They were just very quiet. So I wish they would have spoke up and encouraged. Because it seems that they can do it for Rawls, but I don't understand why they can't do it for us based on the needs that were shown in the court for us. And that's what they went on. But they were not terribly discouraging. I mean, I'm still going to be optimistic. I hope to see what they give us in 2 weeks. I hope that the House, the state delegates do ask them to work with us. It would definitely be in favor of all. If we won't have these negative discussions the city always over this water, I imagine our relationship would be a lot better, not only between us and the city, but even amongst commissioners. So it just seems silly that we have all these arguments over this. I mean, it'd be very simple. And I do want to clarify some. The 37 million gallons a day is for the city and the county. I know it got a little bit confusing. That's max. It doesn't matter what the city claims their pipe will take in. And they have told me 106 million gallons. However, we don't have an engineer report to substantiate that. And there are some people who think if you got a true engineer report with the turbine spinning, it may only be 80 or 90, but that's irrelevant. Because the fact is, 37 million gallons a day is all the combined permits will allow us to do. Ours 16, theirs is 21, and that's just the way it is. So it doesn't matter if you're buying 66% of that pipe or not, you're still not going to get your 66% of 106 million like you were asking.
66% of what does come out of the pipe?
Yeah, of what you can only get with permits allowed to get. It doesn't matter what that pipe is right now. It just doesn't matter. So if there's any other questions anybody's a little bit not too clear on, that we may be able to help you a little bit to get to a fact.
Did you have any discussions with the EPD about the cost of purchasing raw water from the city?
Oh, I'm sorry, say it again.
Did you have any discussions with EPD about the cost of what the city is charging us for raw water?
I explained, and of course, he is asking me if there's any discussion about what the city's charges for the raw water and what they can and can't charge it. And no, they didn't give me a clear answer on that. I know what you're getting at. They did not say that they couldn't charge us anything they wanted to. They didn't want to get into anything that might or may not be a court battle. They didn't want to get any legal advice, I can tell you that. Yeah, that's the point. Yes, ma'am.
Todd, I understand that Brian and I believe Pete went down to meet with the EPA also.
You'll have to ask them.
I'd like to know what they told or were told in their meeting.
Almost finished.
I can't speak to what y'all.
That's what I'm saying. I'd like to have Brian
or Pete
tell us what they were doing or what they
have. He has to go on the microphone and come up.
Might be a little bit more confused now than we were when you got here. And so, well, tonight we're talking about a water contract with City Cumming. We've had many water meetings in this room over the years. I'll tell you what we're not talking about. We're not talking about a reservoir in Lumpkin County or a reservoir in Dawson County, or the Glades Reservoir. I'll get to it, man. Just let me if I could. Because we've ruled them out. We've ruled them out. We've spent most of the past year and a half looking at each one of them, and we've ruled them out, and we've come to the conclusion that we're gonna have to do something with water with the city of Cumming. I don't think you hear any board members here tonight saying, we're gonna get water out of the lanes. So yes, ma'am, I did go to meet with the EPD on Monday, Commissioner Amos and I. You know, that's, I went last year to the EPD. I think that's the third EPD director they've had in 4 years, maybe. EPD serves as the pleasure of the governor. We do not have any, they don't answer to the General Assembly, to legislatures or state senators. However, in our meeting, the legislatures and state senator was in our meeting on Monday, and they were very helpful, all of them. So much so that the director of the EPD encouraged that we negotiate and we have a dialogue with the city of Cumming. Because see, the General Assembly doesn't, and this would be so simple if the General Assembly said, this is how you're gonna divide up sales tax, by land mass or by population, or, but they don't. You're forced to negotiate. We had such a good meeting on Monday that we went back on Tuesday and asked the mayor of the city to come to me and say, so we could all hear the same thing. With our state legislatures, both of them, two out of three, and our state senator. We're talking about water not only for today, but for the future. If you look up there, yes, you're right. We probably could have produced more of our own water, not had to have bought it from the city of Cumming. But when somebody made that contract 25 years ago, how would they know that?
Brian, did you ask the EPD to increase our permits?
Oh, yeah.
You did?
Sure.
Dave,
I appreciate you being here at all.
I can even see that from here.
Day average. This is where we produce our own water. Everything above that we need from somebody else. Everything above that we need from somebody else. We can get a permit today to get water out of Chattahoochee. We can. I mean, that's what the stay is on. 11 million gallons out of the Chattahoochee. So if we get that permit today, you're still 5 years away from treating it properly. You're gonna pump it 14 miles uphill up Old Man Road to take it to the Antioch water treatment plant. Or you're gonna build a plant down on Chattahoochee, one or the other. It was mentioned earlier that Magnuson's ruling was overturned, and it was. However, that ruling to overturn Magnuson's ruling is on appeal. So we are nowhere near being out of the water wars with Florida and Alabama. And while we can, you know, cite, and I mean, Tim, that was a wonderful presentation. And Tim and his department does a great job. Maybe there was an inconsistency in a huge government bureaucracy that's had three different directors in the past 4 years. That's possible. If they, in fact, gave a surface water permit to, Alpharetta Roswell. But I'm sure that it wasn't 11 million gallons like we're talking about getting out of Chattahoochee. It was something much, much smaller than that. Right now, Tim made touched on earlier about we tried to build our own intake on Lake Lanier off Pilgrim Mill Road. I would say to pull 65 million gallons if we were to out of that intake, it would probably cost us in the neighborhood of $25 to $30 million. Tim, would you tell me?
I believe our estimate was 25 to 30, but it was for like 140. It was big enough for both county and city for redundancy. That was okay. The cost estimate, rough.
Just to throw some point of reference, yes, right now there's a bill, if you will, to pay part of the intake for 11.4 million gallons that could, in the future, provide 65 million gallons a day. Back to the reservoirs, the cheapest price tag on reservoirs is $400 million. That's the cheapest. Then it goes to $600, the next one, $700 million for the one after that. And at the end of all that, $400 million, $600 million, $700 million, you know what we are at the end of all that? We're a water customer. We don't have the rights to any of the water in any of those reservoirs that people are trying to get us to sign up for.
But we're a customer of Cumming, the city of Cumming.
Sure we are.
So, yeah.
But we don't spend $400 million to be.
But is it, it has been heard around and said that you and Pete and your crew basically asked the EPD not to work with the county and to continue with us having to buy everything from the city of Cumming.
Well, like you started out, it has been said. It is an election year. So I would go ahead and ask you to ask Representative Dungeon, Representative Hamilton, or State Senator Murphy, or the EPD director himself, who was there for the meetings on Monday, and then again on Tuesday.
Can you tell us specifically what changes the permits you requested?
We talked particularly about the Chattahoochee, because that is the one that has the stay on it.
We didn't talk about changing the 37 million gallon
allocation
between the city and the county.
Sure.
Can you tell us the specifics of what you proposed to the EPD?
We talked about how the permit got to be where it is, and they said, we will talk to you both together. That anything we do for Forsyth County, we're going to do in tandem with the city government.
Well, you didn't say we would like to see 24 million gallons a day for the county, 16 or 14 for the city, or whatever. You didn't give them a specific reallocation number that you would like.
We talked about reallocation, and that would have to come with the permission of the city government. They would have to let some of that go.
Answer my question. Did you ask for a specific reallocation number from the EPD?
I asked about a reallocation. Whether it's 24 million or 31 million or 17 million, we talked about a reallocation. But to think a reallocation.
In generality, it doesn't really help you.
Well, sure it does. When you're having a conversation with the EPD director about a reallocation, and they say the only way we're going to touch a permit is if the city of Cumming signs off. And what I recommend you do, is you have a dialogue and you negotiate with them.
Why would the city have to sign off on the EPD or your allocation? It's the EPD's permit. It's not the city's permit.
Because they said so. They give it out. You're right. You just said it yourself. That's the rules they laid down. It's the EPD's permit. It's not the city's permit. And it's not our permit. Now, is it?
No, it's not.
Sorry.
Brian.
We have a new water plant, clean water plant, coming online in July. If we get the permit from the EPD to clean more water. And we're currently buying raw water at 10 cents per thousand. What can we clean that water for ourselves?
50, 60 cents.
We're paying $2.43 right now to the city. We pay that first before we buy clean water from them first, before we buy or before we do any of our own water.
It's mixed throughout the year. you know, as we go along, we're buying water at the same time we're treating our own.
When you were down there, Ron, did you ask them to get that permitted? Because obviously that's a huge...
Yes, actually I did.
...for the county. Why would the city want to sign off on when they're making $2.43 every thousand on the first 4+ million gallons?
Sure.
That doesn't make...
His response was, there's talk down there at the, amongst the General Assembly, not to let people build plants without permits. That was his response. Because I doubt we're a unique situation. That was his response.
Tim, did we have permits? We got permits to actually build the plant, did we not?
Yeah, we had to get
them. And we were just looking for the final permission, correct?
You know, part of the plant, the new expansion will, can be utilized under our existing permit. We can't get all the way up to the full amount. We'll be positioned to later, whenever.
They were quite clear it was going to be no problem for us to finalize those permits once all inspections were done. To me, they were quite clear with that.
But no increase in permit. So
you'll be able to finish your 28 million a day, then it'll give you your 14, an additional 14.
If I could store enough water somewhere else, I could treat the full amount, you know, using that facility.
Correct. But they're not going to hold out on that plan. I mean, we've got our correct permits in time to enter it.
They haven't for us. I mean, there's no reason for it to. They just care how much water you withdraw. They don't care how many guinea pigs, you know, how much you use of your plant for redundancy or anything else. So they typically let counties overbuild infrastructure. This last year we had a filter blowout. We lost 25% of the plant. So they look at it that way. The extra plant capacity, is just that. It's redundancy and backup for emergencies. But they, you know, they made it real clear, you know, unless something is worked out with permits, we can't treat more than what we have.
I'm going to make something else. I know it's been brought up that if we could get the 11 or possibly 12 million gallons a day out of the river, that long pipe is going to cost us a lot of money. And Tim showed a chart that you couldn't see a little while ago, but it was showing in 20 years if we could deal with our unfinished water, that's a savings of $103
million.
And it's approximately $19 million, if I'm correct, to run that pipe from the river. Doesn't take long to recover your money back, if that's correct. So $19 million run a pipe from the river.
The estimate for that was $19 million.
So it still seems a feasible way to go. Even if we got them out of the river, $19 million seems cheap out of $103 million savings.
Yes, but how long would it take to do that?
So you do a temp, you do your shorter term? Permanent, so that's all.
Sure.
You get some realistic numbers, and then you go with it that way, just don't automatically sign the document.
I think that's a great idea. I think if we can get a 5-year extension on the finished contract, we want it 5 to 7.
We don't need finished water from the city for 5 years, though. Why would we get an extension?
We don't.
Sure we do.
But we cannot finish more than 14 million gallons in our current plant.
Correct.
And we built this plant at risk. The state says that, and they're going to put a stop to it. Let me finish. Okay. I know last year we didn't use as much water. But some years we do, months we depend on the city. We piggyback the city.
We buy it.
And we buy finished water from them.
But we buy it as we need.
But this was a 25-year contract. We haven't even made an offer to the city yet for a new contract. I mean, this county didn't even have a contract or a water plant when it did this contract. So this is 25 years old, so we keep talking about this contract. It's up. It's time to do a new contract.
But you're talking about extending it.
That's
what Brian just said. We extend this contract.
Sure, I said short term on the finished water. If we don't have a permit, we don't need it because if we don't have a permit to finish our water.
If we can only finish 14 million and need 20 million one day, who are we going to get it out?
You're going to buy a PC when you need it. But you're not going to extend the contract that says you have to buy $4 million a day.
Well, I would tell you don't need the one thing.
I never said 4 million gallons a day.
No.
You said extend the existing contract. The existing contract says you have to buy 4 million a day on average.
Price and quantity to be negotiated. You need to buy finished water from that.
That's not an extension. That's a renegotiation. You said extend the existing contract.
Thank you, Hal. Renegotiation. How's that?
That's fine. If you're talking about renegotiating.
Okay. And I'll say one thing about buying water when you need it from the city of Cumming.
Please go to the microphone.
Okay. one thing about buying water from the city of Cumming when you need it. Well, probably more than one thing. First of all, it's not sitting on the shelf. It has to be produced. Okay? And this water, cost more money to finish than this one. Historically, traditionally, when the lake is lower, there's more sediment per gallon. What's that got to do with what?
Demand. You said when the lake is down, demand, when the lake is up or down.
That's right. But the cost to finish the water when the lake is down can be more than the cost to finish the water when the lake is up. So if you buy it when you need it, are you going to buy it at market price? Because right now we can buy it at Gwinnett for, what, $3.03 a gallon. We can buy it from Gwinnett at $3.03 and get out of the $2.42. Do you support that?
The point is, you don't need to buy water between October and April. So why would you?
Now,
that's correct.
Okay. 5 years from now.
5 years from now, hopefully, we're going to have
hopefully.
So you write a contract that says we buy so much for the next 5 years. We have an option to extend that for another 5 years if we need it. If we don't, we get out.
Okay. What'd you say? It's time to renegotiate.
Said 5 years, didn't I?
Okay, well, I've been hearing you can extend the existing contract.
You have never heard me say extend the finished water for 25 years.
Yeah, I actually did hear you say that in working on this.
25 years.
Well, I don't know about 25 years. You said extend the, you made a motion finished to water. Extend the existing contract.
I'd like to say one thing. Everybody keeps asking about the EPD. Mr. Turner stood there and he said, this water is like a ladder. See, we've got numerous rungs to climb up. And the closer we get to the top, we're going to get to the top one day, and then we're going to have to deal with the Endangered Species Act. So, you know, it was all a roundabout. You know, one day we're going to get all this finished, and then we'll look at permits, but that's one day, I don't know when. And it's like, we've got to go through all this legal hurdle, get to the top, then we start more legal hurdles. Like we said in the paper that came out earlier this week, Georgia spent $18 million in the last few years fighting this thing. With Alabama, they haven't even got to court yet. They're just filing papers right now. So we're just stuck in the middle of this water war. Yes, ma'am.
I have a question. Wouldn't it have seemed better and have worked out better if you two had decided to work with Jim and Todd and going down there together, putting up a united front? Did you represent the city of Cumming or the county of Forsyth? And your
you all both had relations with the city,
right?
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
To me, it's a conflict of interest that you're even dealing with the city. Yes. One has restaurants, the other
has the city. Let me answer a question about.
I would just like to.
Let me answer a question first. Commissioner Levent and Commissioner Boff did not ask us to go with them. Mr. Murphy asked us if we'd like to come down after. We had no idea until Saturday before the meeting.
You're not mad enough to say, hey, Jim, hey, Todd.
You never told us you were going.
I didn't know they were going.
You never told those of us you were going. You were the commission. You never told them until you got back. That's really good.
First thing
you've got to learn to do is communicate with your
fellows. They didn't tell us. Not with the mayor.
We communicate with the mayor, talk to the men on the board.
They didn't ask us to go with them.
Well, no, why'd you ask them?
The mayor. No, I didn't ask the mayor.
That's
not what
I was told.
Mr. Turner. Because Mr. Turner asked the mayor. But
one of our state delegations called the mayor and asked him to do this.
Yes.
Do you think
I'll just say one thing,
sit here for an hour and 31 minutes like everybody else. And I think that you and Bobby Amos should recuse yourself in these negotiations.
Okay. Well, you're entitled to your opinion, and I'll just refer you to my voting record for 8 years.
I'm good.
Voting record is what it is.
Very wary of politicians.
I don't know.
and no matter what level.
Show us the mayor's transit.
Yeah, right. And you're in, you know, with your restaurant and that the mayor owns and whatever, you know, you have, you can't say no to them. So, and like you mentioned, as far as Amos' family, they own, you know, Boo's the property in the county, so it's understandable why you would be sticking up for the citizens.